another week.
Just to see you.
To behold.
To behold you as my king.
For the music, for the singing. I want to just hear the saints just worship. Come on. If there's a true worship in the house, just give it some true worship. Just give it some true worship. Somebody said, all hail the power of Jesus' name. Let angels prostrate fall. Bring forth the royal diadem. And we crown him. Can somebody crown him? Come on, just forget about your neighbor. Forget about what's behind you, in front of you. And just begin to give some true worship. Yeah, God. If you need to close your eyes, whatever you need to do, just forget about everything and begin to give God some true worship. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. It was Jesus who said, if I be lifted up from this earth, then I will draw all men. So saints, when we begin to lift him up, then God begins to do the drawing. Somebody lift him up. Somebody lift him up. Somebody lift him up. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Hallelujah. Go ahead. Go ahead and just worship. Go ahead and continue to worship. Go ahead. This is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And we allow God to have his way in this house. Oh, we allow God to have his way in this house. At any time he chooses, any time he pleases, sir. Ah, God. Glory, 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 glory. You see, the thing about us, as human beings, we have a tendency to depend on people. Am I talking to somebody? You see, in the Garden of Eden, when God made man, he said this, that it was not good for man to be alone. You see, that can't change because God made us to fellowship. God made us to communicate with somebody. It not only meant that it was not good some man should get married, but it means that we have a tendency to communicate. We always need somebody. We always need somebody to talk to. Have you ever met somebody who's just miserable, who's just terrible, who's just awful to the point where you can't stand them, but yet that person is married? Am I talking to somebody? So it means that even they need somebody to communicate with. Am I talking to the church? And so now it is in us to always need somebody. But you see, God is breaking us or getting us to a point to understand this, that there is a point in your life where you can depend on your brother or your sister. This is what God wants us to understand, that even your brother encourages you. The encouragement is not coming from them. Even your sister blesses you. God, that blessing is not coming from your sister. You see, God is getting us to a point where our dependency doesn't come by man. Because when we depend on man, if we don't see our brother, then we say to ourselves, then I'm dead. No, because I don't see the person who can help me. Am I talking to somebody? Have you ever been to a place in your mind where you've been discouraged and you have a brother or a sister or a good friend where you can always call, you can always expect to get a word from the person, but then you call the person and you get busy signal? Am I talking to somebody? So when that happens, you feel as if the world is over, but God is trying to get you to the point where your dependency is completely on him. So when he comes to God, he wants to get you to that place where you stop depending on mommy, you stop depending on daddy. I heard David said that when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. I heard David said, some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but we will remember the name of the Lord, for the name of the Lord is a strong and mighty tower. The righteous run in and are saved. You see, God wants you to get you to that place where you depend completely on him. You have got to be willing to press amidst the distress. Can I get an amen for my little boy there? Praise God. Can I just say something to you? I said this on Thursday night, but I want to encourage somebody who's walking with God or somebody who's a backslider in the house. Let me put something to you. I said it to the church on Thursday night. I came here and I could not manage to lift my hands. I decided in my mind, because before I got married, and let me explain again, as I said on Thursday night, me stop going to the gym had nothing, right, to do with me getting married, right? Good. All right, so we established that. Bless God. God bless you. Praise God. So I got married. Praise God. And so I start away from the gym. Ministry start. Life gets more difficult. So if I say I don't have any time to go to the gym, so I used to go to the gym, keep my body fit, because I'm from what we call a big bone set of people. We don't call it fat, we call it big bone. Praise God. So I remember one day I went up to my house to look for my sister. And what really hit me, I didn't even say it to you, but I'll tell the church now you're here. What really hit me was my sister said, "But Steve, you know, sister, a daddy belly you have." Oh Jesus, praise God. Hallelujah. So me as a young man here, say, "I'm a daddy belly me have." Praise God. So I said, "But no, sir, something, this can't work." So what happened is that all in my mind was I wanted to go back to the gym. But when I thought about the hard work, when I thought about the fact that because I had not been to the gym for so long, my body, my muscles were going to be in tear pain, I kept on withholding. I kept on putting it aside. My wife, once in a while, she would drop a little word, you know? Touch me, drop a little word. I said, "Look on your belly." You know, them look nice if you think them. Yes. So look on your belly and touch your steering. Praise God Almighty. Praise God. She said it in love. She said it in love. Praise God. So all those things, I took it as motivation because I know what I had to do. But guess what? To get there was the problem. So I was in a position where I knew what I had to do. But to do it was a problem. I started to make excuses. All right, I want to get some more health products to drink and so on. And when I get more healthy, then I go to the gym. Excuses! So, one day, I get some money. A missionary had some things to do. You know what I mean? Just take the money, can't go to the gym, and pay down the membership. I didn't think about it. Didn't question it. I just paid down on it because me now gonna make your money go to waste. So I went to the gym and did one day. And when I did the one day, I felt good. Felt like I was on cloud nine. I felt that, my God, I could just run through a troop and leap over a wall. I felt good. When I got home, I sat down. And the reality start to kick in, and the most of them start say, "Oi, why you not doing this a while ago? We don't feel too good." I felt some pain in my body. I couldn't lift my hand. I have to call my wife, say, "Come take off my shirt, please." But then I bed, me can't move. Me don't know if I drive the car. I was in pain. All my wife could undo. I said, And let me tell you something she do too. She look at me and laugh. She laugh at me too. Praise God. But in my mind, I knew within myself that the pain comes with the process. So if I just continue to work through the pain, praise God. If I continue to press through the pain, praise God. So when everybody was laughing at me in the car because them see me can't stretch my hand, I know what I know in myself. Can I tell you something? There's coming a day when God is going to bring you before your enemies, them. And watch her, praise God. Watch her, watch her, watch her, watch her. Hallelujah. Somebody give God some glory.
Committed to the journey, so me now go backslide. Looking through the spirit and not physical eyes. Ooh, to God me testify. Know me at the work of God and the boss. My whole life, he endows. Take me from the mud and put me in a head.